At long last, the Imperial blockades of Diskaian roadways have been removed. The Imperial Army has also demolished all related facilities erected around the region. The Provisional Government of Insomnia anticipates increased traffic congestion along most local highways and encourages all citizens to refrain from any unnecessary travel for the time being.
So help me figure this out. That was Luna's brother?
The High Commander himself. Wartime makes for quick promotions.
Even a son of Tenebrae can rise to the top.
But why would he want to lead their army?
Who cares?
Certainly formidable enough on his own.
Ugh. If Ravis wants power, I'll give him a taste.
Ready for more?
You bet.
Let's hit it.
Hot out here.
Just need to pull in somewhere cool.
Yeah.
Any chance of sleeping in a nice room tonight?
Yes, I'm certain we can secure suitable accommodations nearby.
Oh, Gladdy.
What's wrong?
I let you down. I never made it to Kaim. The Empire came. While you were gone, none of us said a word about Nacht. They just showed up and then... Poor Jared.
What do you mean? What happened to Jared?
There was nothing we could do!
Should have been here.
I couldn't stop them.
But I won't let the Empire get away with it. They'll pay for what they've done, I promise.
I believe in you, Prince Noctis.
I'm taking Talcott. And we're going to Kaim. We can't just stay here and do nothing.
I understand.
I can't let her go it alone, after everything that went down. It'll be a squeeze in the car, but just for a while.
Shall we, then?
Yeah, I don't want to keep Sid and Cindy waiting. They're fixing up the boat as we speak.
We ought to thank them.
Actually, Jared's the one we ought to thank.
Yeah. He really thought of everything.
The little boy wouldn't stop crying for his grandpa.
Oh no, the poor thing.
I hope that Imperial scumbag gets what's coming to him.
Filled her up for ya.
Thanks.
Ready to roll? Let's get this show on the road. Morning! Who's ready to kick some ass? Looking at the regalia really reminds me of home.
It sure doesn't look like any of the cars you see around here.
And it's a lot roomier, too. I can't imagine trying to cram 5 people, including Gladdy, into one of those things. Have you ever ridden in one?
Can't say we have.
There was barely enough room for our luggage. Thank goodness you guys could give me a lift.
Think the others made it to Kaim all right?
I suppose we'll find out when we get there.
Check it out! See that? That's the Rock of Ravito. I'm like 90% sure.
Not 100.
You almost know your stuff.
All thanks to Jared. Thank you for driving, Ignis.
Pleasure.
Are you the only one that drives?
I can drive!
And so can I.
It's not like Iggy's the only one who can drive. He's just the only one we can trust.
Wow, are they that bad?
Not bad at all, right?
Right. But there's no way the big guy's taking any chances with his little sister in the car.
Sure you don't need a break?
I'm okay.
You are sandwiched in back there.
Have Prompto suffer instead.
Really, it's fine. No suffering here.
If you say so.
I got some bad news, guys!
Oh, great. Another floating fortress.
Let's pull over.
Knocked.
Relax. We've got this.
Taking matters into hand?
Delivering justice for Jared.
And for Talca, too.
Iris, I'll need you to wait here.
All right.
Careful, Noct. Only fools rush in. I suggest we review our intelligence and devise a plan.
Thank you for shopping with us. Take care, and come again.
That's it!
What's up, Iggy?
I've come up with a new recipe.
I could taste test for you. Huh?
So you mean the High Commander's left arm is completely artificial?
Yes, that's what prosthetic means. I assume he had it made while undergoing treatment back in the Empire. It seems they imbued the arm with Magitech, the same technology they used to power their entire nation. Technology they appropriated from an ancient civilization. The point is that the arm's not just for show. It packs a pretty punch. Pardon the pun.
Welcome to the original Crow's Nest Diner, where it all began.
Ah, hankering for information. Well, is there anything in particular you'd like to know?
Anything tickle your fancy? Very good. We'll whip it up right away.
I dare say I could make this a camp.
Well, if you're game, these feisty fiends are keen to play. Kenny and I look forward to seeing you again.
Be safe. I'll be here waiting.
Oh, new faces. And weary ones at that. How's about a room?
It's bedtime.
Iris.
Scary to think that fortresses can fly.
Iris isn't exactly a bring-em-on backstreet brawler, is she?
She's tough, but I'd feel better if we got this over with and got back on the road.
This'll be quick.
Gotcha!
Onward.
Yep.
So, what's our plan?
Find the base commander and take him into custody. Targeting Metal Man will yield little in the way of reconnaissance, but bones bend easily. We'll split into two groups of two. Prompto and Gladio will generate a diversion.
Oh yeah, making a scene's what I do best.
Noct, are you prepared?
Operation to catch a commander is go.
The insolence of that up-jumped mercenary.
And there is still no word. This cannot be borne. Such behavior besmirches his Radiance's good name.
That's our target. Let's follow him. Seize him on my signal. Stay hidden till then.
What is that Chancellor playing at? I'm no man's fool. He sent Highwind to watch me. It's no mere coincidence she and I meet wherever I go. Claims to trust her as a person. Hollow words from the mind behind the Magitek movement. I may have acted in haste with that impudent steward back in the Stalum, but my mission remains clear. And I'll be damned if that mercenary gets her grubby hands on the prince before Caligo Uldor. I'll give Highwind one last chance to respond. Stand guard here. If the Commodore arrives, send her through.
Now's your chance, Noct. Close in from behind. And remember, we need him alive.
Don't worry.
Yeah, you're in fine form. Keep it up. Looks like they've set to work. I'll escort him off the base. You regroup with the others.
Guess it's time to let loose.
Thank you.
Glad to see you lot were successful.
Does that mean you weren't?
I placed our captive into the Hunter's custody, but I've just been informed he's fled. He lives to die another day.
And I'll gladly help him with that.
Hey, pretty boy.
Let's see what you can do.
Got a tough one on your hands.
End of the line! Pathetic! Too slow!
Time already?
What time?
Quitting time. Sorry, but this girl doesn't work after hours. I could, but there wouldn't be a single gill in it for me. We should play again sometime, pretty boy.
Who the hell was she?
I'm still worried about Iris.
I imagine she's fine,
but we shouldn't keep her waiting.
You're back. Did you kick their asses?
Oh yeah.
All in a day's work.
Hey, mind if I hang in your guys' room for a bit?